Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And today I'm very excited because you will be seeing this recording, which I had done with Sunili Jani Pawarji from Planet to Soul Astrology. She's very famous and she has many videos on Navamsha and other divisional charts and so many other remedies in her channel. You must have already seen so many of her videos. And I had also done a recording with her, but that time she interviewed me, but this time it's her interview and I forgot to introduce her in the beginning. So I've made this introduction myself, and this video is on the Shamsha chart, and so many wonderful things she has said, like if sometimes you have a planet in a particular house, but then you see that that planet is not giving you those expected results when it comes to your career. Why is it not giving you that? What is that which is hindering you from bringing that to the professional front? Okay, it could be that is linked to your Dashamsha chart. Okay, so therefore, please watch this video, and I will pin the link of her YouTube channel down, and also her website, planet2soul.com. You can go there, and she has tons of online courses, and she also does consultations. And I'll also pin her email address below. All right. So thank you, Sunili ji, once again. And please enjoy the recording.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And we have a very beautiful guest today in Exotic Astrology. Sunili ji is here. Welcome. And this is the second time we are meeting. Last week, she had interviewed me for Navamsha. And that video has been uploaded already, but today she will speak on the Shamsha chart. Okay, I'm very eager and enthusiastic. Maybe this is the first time somebody is speaking on the Shamsha in Exotic Astrology. And welcome, oh, really? Madam. Stage is yours.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Babaji. This is an extreme pleasure to talk on your channel. And you already talked about Navamsha and career when we talked last time, and I think on 6th of March, we are going to upload that video.
Right.
So, today, I'll be talking about D10 chart. You know, all the degrees are bifurcated, and the bifurcated degrees are given particular names as Navamsha, Dashamsha, Dwadashamsha. Likewise, you know, D9, D10, D60, and then lastly, D12 are very famous divisional charts. You know, people run after those charts in research also, in learning also, and in predictions also. So, as you know, that minute form of each house is divided by making divisional charts. And when we talk about D10 chart, so the 10th house represents our D10 chart. 10th house is not only our profession or whatever work we are going to do every day, but this is our karma. That is why we say that Saturn is connected to karma as per nature's chart. 10 number sign falls in 10th house, and 11 number, that means whatever karma you will do, you will get gains of that karma. That also Saturn will only decide. Not other sign is given. Saturn is only deciding whether to give you karma phal or no. Same way, when we say that in my D1 chart, I am finding so many good yogas, there is a Venus in my third house, but I am not at all creative. Because in Parakram Sthana, Venus goes. Maybe my handwritings are good, but I am not creative. I do not know painting. Or I am not in good, I do not like music as well. Then what that Venus indicates? Because in your D10 chart, maybe this Venus is getting affliction, or this Venus is not a major planet of your D10 chart in terms of career. Sometimes what happens, our 10th lord also goes in third house of chart.
Correct.
Which becomes 6, 8 to each other. Then we say that maybe my Parakrama will not be that much, fruitful, because the 10th house and 10th lord are 6-8 to each other. So maybe I will follow many struggles, and after certain struggle only I'll be getting little fruit. Whatever I'm giving or 100% I am giving, but I am gaining only 30 to 40% out of that, and my whole life is going in struggles only, just meeting ends of month. I'm not able to save a single money. So totally our 10th house, 10th Lord, as in D1 chart, we see our Artha Trikona, that is 2, 6, 10. Same way in professional chart also, in D10 chart also, that is called as a Dashmansh, Dashansh, whatever you call it as. So in D10 chart, you know, this is 3 degrees are given to each house, and then your circle is getting over. On other note, I was majorly to speak about deities falling in our D10 chart, but that needs a little bit of, you know, keen attention towards that, because there is a odd signs and even signs. Our planets are posited. Some planets are in even sign, some planets are in odd signs, and definitely according to those planets, you can generate your D10 chart manually also. Or nowadays in software, we are seeing all these charts, right? But you know, every planet is holding one deity in our D10 chart. I will just give you simple example. If your any planet is like 3 degrees are given to each house, right?
Yes.
So within 0 to 3 degree, if your any planet is posited in odd sign or even sign. So if it is posited in odd sign, say 0 to 3 degree, your Venus is posited in Aries sign, then the deity will be Indra Devata for that. And this, for this deity also, particular direction is given. So for Indra Devata, east direction has been provided. So you should work your efforts towards east direction. Or whatever work you are starting, the east zone, east horizon is your territory where you have to give your best. So Indra Devata will definitely try to give you utmost fruit as per your struggles. Definitely we have to see other planets also.
Correct.
But same way, if this 0 to 3 degree Venus is posited in your even sign, right? First I talked about odd sign. Now if 0 to 3 degree is in even sign,
yes,
then the deity is Ananta, which is
okay,
the utmost deity.
Okay.
Ananta means which doesn't have any end.
Correct.
The tunnel is never ending tunnel, and that tunnel is of success.
Okay. Okay.
And then this is like, you know, Urdhvamukhi, that is seeing upside, that planet. And disha wise or direction wise, because see, 10 portion are divided into dasha disha. You always say na dasha disha. 8 are 4 are major directions, then other 4 are sub directions, and 2 are Rahu and Ketu. That is sky element and earth element. So total 10 directions are there. Those 10 directions as per deities are converted into D10 chart. So if one want to research or one want to see that how my planet will give me fruit, say for example, in your D10 chart, your 10th Lord is going in 9th house of chart. So definitely you will see a lot of success, but at the same time in your working area or work profile, you will change many work. You will see many changes in your work span. You know, maybe before 5 years you were working with somebody. Now after 2 years you started your own work, then again you are going towards becoming salaried person, and then again you are doing both the things, like doing business also and earning through job also. So our D10 chart totally decides that what type of characteristic we have within us to perform our daily task for ourselves and for our family, to earn livelihood as well as towards our karma. Karma plays very, very important role here. Today, I will be, jumping to that, I will just tell you the deity's name at least, so
okay,
that
yes,
people will be aware about it. So, if your Vishama Rashi or odd signs are from 0, 3, 3, 6, 6 to 10 degrees, 6 to 9 degrees, then 9 to 12 degrees, 12 to 15 degrees. Likewise, 30 degrees will get over when 27 to 30 degrees will fall, right?
Yes.
So if you have planet in or sign in your chart, then definitely first will be 0 to 3 degree. Now you have to match with your degrees. So it will be Indra Devata, as I said before. Then 3 to 6 degree in or sign, it will be Agni Devata. So the fruit will be connected to Agni. Too much of energy or facing any type of situation, courageous person, getting fruits but with lots of efforts, because Agni is something that you are jumping towards a situation without thinking about the fruit. Then right. If 6 to 9 degrees, then it is Yama Devata. Yama Devata means you are a brave person but you are getting 50-50% fruits. Yama Devata will give you fruits like that only. Or you can say that more of struggles. People complain that no, I'm not getting fruits, or I'm not getting whatever I'm putting in terms of finance, in terms of efforts, I'm not able to get it back. That time you will see that your planet of odd sign falling in 6 to 9 degrees is holding Yama deity.
Okay.
So you have to make prayers towards south zone of your horoscope. Then you have to check your south zone of your horoscope as per Astro Vastu.
Okay.
Then you can definitely reveal some new things that yes, now this is where the problem is lying in my chart and I have to work towards it. So if a planet is of 9 to 12 degrees, then Rakshash Devata. Rakshash is a demon.
Correct.
So it's like fight, sham, dam, danda, bhed, everything I will try and I will, by hook or crook, I will get the work done. And there will be some type of pressure on others because of you. People will work, but people will not adore you.
So it's like they will respect you because of your position, not because of, you know, your behavior.
Yes, absolutely. Okay. That is why I say sometimes we see, this person is so much rich. And when this person is arriving, so many people are standing, they are giving standing ovations.
Correct.
In front of us, that is an ovation. But in those people's mind, there is no respect.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, correct.
That is demon within them. We cannot generalize these things that only Rahu will give demon-like characteristics. Any planet falling in Rakshas deity will definitely do that. Then when we talk about 12 to 15 degrees for odd sign, then Varuna Devata, which is denoting Paschim Disha, that is west zone. Varuna Devata, so Aquarius sign, what we call as, or Saturn also is connected to Varuna Devata. So these people are also like Vayu, they are very deep thinkers. And always they have capacity to gulp everything within them, whether it is sorrow or whether it is happiness. In their career also, they will not complain much. Whatever comes on their way, they will just go ahead with it. And they are like, even though they know that nothing is going to improve, and they are somewhat lazy people also. They will not try. And all of a sudden, they have an idea that, no, now I will run after my work. Same with another degree, which is 15 to 18 degree, the deity is Vayu.
Okay.
Pavana Putra Hanuman Jaisa. Like, they are, now I am talking to you about D10 chart. Maybe if my particular planet, say Mercury, is in Vayu, then immediately I will jump to another topic only.
Okay.
I will be deviated. Same way, profession-wise also, these people are working towards one goal, one task, but again, they are deviating their mind towards another goals. And that first goal is remained as it is, and then they are complaining that we are not getting success.
Okay.
Because you are not properly stick to that particular goal or task. You have endless ideas in your mind. This is just a generalized idea I am giving about this.
Yes.
And then you have to see that characteristic of that particular planet also plays very important role. Mercury like planet is always a dual personality, like dual mind. You have more than 1, 2, 3 profession, and then you want share market also, you want to sell some things on Amazon also, you want to write a book also, you want social media also, you want to earn money also, and you want to be good also with everyone. See, this is today's reality.
Yeah, this is like all the time I keep getting these mails, you know, this is not working, that is not working, and then like, which one do you want to work first? And they're like, no, I want everything.
I want everything. See, this is a human tendency. You cannot change it.
Yes.
But you know, people having this in particular deity area, then definitely they are more keen and they become dukhi also. Like they are in sorrow moment, you know. But who are not, then maybe even though they do not like it, but they are overcoming the situation. This is the difference.
Correct.
Remaining always in grief, always in negativity, is that planet particularly working on you. Coming out of that grief, coming out of that mental agony is something different, that you are working on that particular zone. Another planet is very powerful in your chart. That is why you are able to come out of this situation. And this is a single deity I am saying. Maybe your major planet or functional benefic planet may be into Ananta Devata. Right. So maybe that planet will bring you out of this all situation, and your profession will be in an aligned manner. Your career will be very, very goal-oriented career, and then you will not have many things in your mind. Automatically, situations will come in front of you. Changing situation also, that I'm getting such and such opportunities and I'm happy with my work. You are finding such people also who are very happy with their work.
Correct.
Everyone is not complaining.
Correct.
They say that I did so much of work, I'm happy with my work, I'm satisfied. This type of people also you get. Because situationally they are getting everything in their life. Then I'll come to 18 to 21 degrees. So there is Kuber. Here comes something. Kuber is Lakshmi. Like, you know, taking care of your money. So planet like Venus, planet like Saturn, or planet like Surya, if falls in Kuber,
yes,
definitely money will come automatically. Like, even though you are not working and you have worked in past and you are not working, or due to any reason, if your regular liquidity of money is not coming, but if you are supposed to get 1 lakh rupees, say for example, per month, somehow that money will come to you.
Okay.
Through any source it will come. That, okay. You know, many people say that, I don't know, I'm not earning anything, lekin ghar chalta hai.
Okay, correct.
My house is running. But Kuber deity is something which will give you lot many opportunities and success with money. Not only name fame, it will give you money out of your work. Then you have to see in your D10 chart that my particular planet like Venus or Saturn or any planet is falling in Kuber, in odd sign, then definitely I should work connected to this planet. And the Disha or the direction is Uttar, that is north. That is why north side is of Kuber. We always say that north, east, you have to keep very light. Because you have to give access to that Lakshmi to enter. If you will keep heavy loadings near to your northeast zone, then definitely how the deities will come. You have to welcome those deities.
Correct, correct.
Right. Same way, if your planet is 21 to 24 degrees, then comes the Ishana Devata.
Okay.
Ishana Devata is making you more spiritual, and your spiritual progress is much better. If your any particular planet like Mercury or Saturn is also going in Ishan, or Surya is also going in with Ishana deity, then after certain point, you feel like spiritually inclining yourself. Everyone is living in material life. Nobody is immediately leaving the house and going to jungle for sadhana. But correct. Living in a material life and being spiritual is something different.
Correct.
Right? And same way, 24 to 27 degrees, then Brahma, Devata, Brahma deity is coming into action. Brahma is the creator of universe. Everyone knows that. So these people think about everyone in their profession also. They want to make happy everyone. And somehow they are becoming victim of not getting creditability of their work. They are like Brahma. I am creating everything for you. I am helping you out. Another person is taking the name. The credit. And then these people are working. They are only creator of the things.
Correct.
But they are getting respect in their profession. Whatever profession they have. Whatever post they are holding. Your post is not important. Yeah, definitely if your planet like Surya is in Kuber deity or it is like in Varuna deity or if it is in Indra deity, then definitely government connected authoritative post position in other organizations also you are supposed to get. Then lastly, when we talk about 27 to 30 degree, then comes the deity of Ananta. Ananta means, as I said before, a big tunnel without any end. You will get endless fruit till your life ends.
Okay.
Through yourself, through your work, through your people, through your relatives, through your friends, through universe, through nature, you are going to get everything. And then when I talk about even signs, then you just have to go down to up.
Okay.
Like if in your even sign planet is in 0 to 3 degree, then Ananta will be the deity for you.
Yes.
If it is in Samarashi. So I'll try to give you that table of this. I'll just search for it. I'll send you so that you can put in between the lecture also.
Okay.
So that people will understand it more. Now coming... Now I will just talk few things about D10 chart, that how you have to assess your D10 chart. I will talk 3 to 4 points over here. So whenever we are assessing our D10 chart, see, there are two methods of assessing the D10 chart. Many methods are there, but majorly one as per paramparik paddhati or as per traditional method, as per deities, we have to assess one's chart. Traditional Jyotishi were reading the deities and then they were giving the predictions.
Correct.
That you have to improve your this zone, you have to improvise, you have to work towards north. People used to say, Uttar mein jao, udhar tumhara udhar hoga. You go towards north, you will get good luck over there. If something is missing in your life or you lost something, then go towards east zone, you will find your thing. This finding of thing for Prashna Kundali also, you can utilize the same method.
Okay.
So, coming back to how to assess your D10 chart, there are many methods, many techniques or many points. But first and foremost point, what you have to see for assessing D10 chart is your ascendant lord of D1 chart, where is going in D10 chart. If your ascendant lord... Yes. If ascendant lord of D1 is powerful in your D10 chart, then you will not change many work.
Okay.
Because you are strong in your profession chart.
Correct.
It is as simple as that. If your ascendant lord being powerful also, but going in 6 at 12.
Yeah.
You are sticking to the same profession, but with many ups and downs.
Okay. Many obstacles. Yes.
Many obstacles. Then you have to see that whether my ascendant lord, even though he is going in a good house, except 6 at 12, but if it is getting afflicted, then also you are not satisfied with your career. You want some change. And always after age 45 also, you have question, what should I do? What is my path? What career I should choose? And when somebody approaches you after their 40 age or 35 age, because basically we see that 25 to 35 is a major crucial lifespan of our life where we have to select our career and we have to work towards that goal. No doubt that age is not a limit for grooming yourself. But specifically, when people are asking after 40, 45 coming for consultations, then definitely you have to advise as per their Mahadasha.
Correct. And yes.
Because
yes.
Whatever planets they have in their chart, that is by birth. But still, if you will say you do some creativity, your Venus is very powerful, or he is not running Venus Dasha, that work will not work for him.
Correct.
He will say, okay, I only like listening to music. Or if Mercury is powerful, okay, I can talk to you very nicely, but I cannot guide others.
Correct.
Because I do not have confidence.
Correct.
Correct. So Ascendant correct. Lord in your D10 chart plays very important role to derive your career and to derive what type of career you will choose. Like Mars will give you work towards defense, army, or you know, soldier type work. Soldier not only means wearing a uniform, but it could be security, or it could be in a bank also, like security department, you are an officer over there.
Correct.
Right. And that also, if Mars like planet, and if it is going in Anuradha Nakshatra in your D1 chart, then definitely you are working towards healing sector, or you are working in a medical profession, or hospital or health sector, anything could be there. So definitely when we see D10 chart, we have to assess this way. Secondly, you have to see 10th Lord of your D10 chart in that D10 chart only. Now I will only talk about professional chart. If your 10th Lord of D10 chart is well placed, then definitely it will give you good fruits. But if 10th Lord of your D10 chart is getting debilitated in D10 chart only, then definitely you are seeing many, many changes in your work profile. You are not sustaining in one work for a longer period of time, nor you are able to make others sustain. You will always grumble in front of your people, you know, I am not happy, I am not satisfied. You will make others also think always that only. Whenever okay. this person is calling, he or she is always grumbling about. That is why 10th Lord of your D10 chart and 10th house, definitely 10th house is always important. That is why we are talking about professional chart. That plays very, very important role. And lastly, moon and sun of D10 chart.
Okay.
Wherever your Chandra and Surya, they are king and queen. In very simple terms, I will say this.
Correct.
If your sun or your moon is powerful in your D10 chart, and even though your ascendant lord is becoming, your ascendant lord of D1 chart is becoming weak in D10 chart,
yeah.
Then also, this will definitely look after the situation. Like after struggles also, you will get huge success because of good sun and moon position. Sun and moon are the pioneer of any predictions. You have to take them in consideration for any type of prediction. You have to see that. And for job specifically, for house, people ask that when my house will happen, I'm staying in my office quarters only, I'm not having my own house or something, then definitely you have to see sun position of D1 and D10. But in D1, if sun is very good position, but in D10, that sun is getting affliction. So in spite of having your own house, you are changing or you are roaming from one place to another because of your work.
Yes.
You are not able to stay in that place. You are buying for your family maybe.
Correct.
You are not able to enjoy that house. You know, you are providing money, you are giving everything, but you are not able to enjoy. That is why sun and moon position of your D10 chart plays very, very important role. And again, I will say that ascendant lord of your D10 chart also plays very crucial role.
Okay.
What ascendant is rising in your D10 chart, that is your actual character, that is your actual nature, how you look at your profession.
Okay.
D1 chart is yourself. How is your look? How is your tendency, your thought process? That is external. But how is your working pattern? That will be derived from ascendant rising of D tension.
Okay. That's like the mentality, you could say.
Mentality towards your work.
Correct.
If Saturn is rising and Saturn is there, then definitely you are very surrendered, dedicated towards your work. You will not leave until and unless your work is over. Okay. But if it is like moon, then you are very moody in working pattern.
Okay.
Like now you are giving 100%. After 2 days, you will say, today I am not in mood. And then your performance maybe is lacking in your office also. But because you did very nice work, your boss will say that, okay, now because you are a good worker, I will not give you memo.
Okay.
So ascendant rising and ascendant lord of your D10 chart will definitely say how you are allowing your own energy towards your work, how you are putting your efforts, how is your attitude towards your work.
Incredible.
Because unless you can just judge in any chart and blindly you can say that you are like this person. If Mercury is rising, like Mithuna Rashi is rising, and Mercury also goes in, say, dual sign, then you will say, till now you are not able to decide only what work you have to do.
Correct.
Or maybe you are working for more than 2-3 sectors. You are earning from many sources.
Yes.
But at the end, at the end, you like only small things. You know, Mercury people do not run after huge things, you know. You see any Mercurian people. They are happy with small things. They become very happy. That is Mercury. Because Mercury is a child planet. Unless and until Saturn or Sun-like planets comes there. Like if Surya getting combust with Mercury or Saturn is with Mercury, then definitely it's like small happiness, but you are not showing on your face. You will show that yet time has to come for me. Then Saturn will start acting with this Mercury. Then Jupiter will say, no, do not become happy with this small event. We have to achieve or we have to expand our work. Then only you are allowed to become happy. Do not become happy till then. Every planet, if we know basic of Jyotish Shastra and Laghu Parashari, then no one can stop you from predicting best and fantastic way. So this was all, Babaji. I tried to make it short and simple. I hope everyone will definitely understand and will get some information out of it. What are your views about D10 chart?
Yeah, I have seen the ascendant of D10. As you said, it's very important. I have seen, especially if dual signs are rising, then I have seen, as you said, people might have two professions, two or more. And then it depends on the ascendant lord. That sometimes I have seen that if the ascendant lord of D10, of D10 chart, not the D1, if the ascendant lord of D10, that is in debility. Then what happens, and if the overall chart is not very good, then the person may feel that they should be doing something else. But then again, as you said, you have to go to the dashas and check if that is something which the Lagna chart agrees to. Because until and unless the Lagna chart will give a platform from the dashas, that thing will not come outside. You know, it doesn't mean it is not there, but checking the Lagna chart along with the dashas and including the dashamsha is very important. Because I always see people in YouTube especially, they say, in my Lagna chart, Venus is in 10th house. So should I have a career related to Venus? But in dashamsha, Venus is not in a good dignity. Then what happens?
No. Then it is not happening. Yes. That is why a professional chart becomes very, very important. And on my channel also, now I'm going to start a D10 series very soon, maybe from next week.
Okay.
You can watch that also. I hope everyone knows my channel's name, Planet to Soul Astrology.
Of course.
I forget to mention in my introduction. So
yeah, I also could not. So yes, I'll pin the channel down in the description. And as usual, I mean, I'm pretty sure everybody would be aware. And you also have your website and you also do consultations. So you will find all the details down in the description section, yes, including your yes. Instagram and Facebook page.
Yeah.
So please,
I have started follow her there.
Yeah, nowadays every astrologer is also updated, you know, Instagram, yeah. Facebook, everywhere. So yes. Yeah, everybody has to. Anyways, thank you so much. It was a great pleasure indeed listening to the Dashamsha. And I guess, and the only thing I would like to say to all the viewers is please understand that you might see one video on the Dashamsha, but you will not understand everything. Okay, so don't think that, okay, what she said here doesn't apply to my chart. It may apply, it may not apply, depending on so many other factors. So look at the D1 and then look at the D10 also, not just one house, one planet, you know, all the read the chart as a separate chart and read it. Okay.
Yes. And like of course, at chart the end, only you have to read. Yes.
And at the end, of course, the dashas always you have to. Yes. Okay. Yes. Thank you very much. And hope to see you soon again. Yes.
Namaste. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Bye.